Now, this frame has a lot of information, so let's take it one step at a time.
First, let's look at the planes of the body, and then we'll look at body directions and positions. Number one is the sagittal plane. The sagittal plane divides the body into the right and left halves. The word sagit in Latin means arrow or like an arrow. It's like an arrow passing through the body, dividing it into a right and left aspect. Number two is the coronal plane. It's also known as the frontal plane. It's easy to remember that this plane divides the body into a front portion and a back portion. This plane passes through the coronal suture or the crowning suture in the middle of the skull, dividing it into a front part of the skull and a back part of the skull. Hence, we get the coronal suture and the coronal plane. Number three is the transverse plane. The transverse plane is also known as the horizontal plane. And trans, of course, means across, and the horizon at a distance goes from right to left. So this plane divides the body into an upper portion and a lower portion. Again, the sagittal plane divides it into the right and left portions. The coronal plane or the frontal plane divides it into the front and back portions. And the transverse or the horizontal plane divides it into an upper and a lower portion. These planes can be used in reference to the body as a whole or in reference to any aspect of the body. An example might be the different planes of the heart. An additional reference is often made to the medial plane or the median aspect of something. The median aspect of a body part would be toward its middle, and the medial aspect of the body is toward the middle, as seen in number four. Now let's look at body directions and positions. Now number five shows you the lateral aspect of something. Remember, lat in Latin means side. Number six is the central portion. Central means the center of something. An example might be the belly button is the center or the central aspect of the human body in its entirety. Number seven, posterior, means that which lies behind or after. In an anatomical position, dorsal can refer to back also. Number eight, anterior, refers to the foremost part of the body. Ventral is sometimes used in referring to the anterior aspect of the human body in a normal anatomical position. Now, in an effort to clarify this a little better, anterior is the front, posterior is the back. If we're not referring to the human anatomical position and using anterior, posterior, ventral, and dorsal, they would refer to different aspects of the body. These terms might be better understood in reference to an animal, like a dog. Anterior would be the dog's head, posterior would be the tail. Dorsal would be its upper back, and ventral, which means belly, is the belly of the dog. Number nine is superior. It means above. Supra also means something that lies above. And occasionally hyper is used in reference to above. Number 10, inferior, means below. Hypo and infra also mean below. Number 11, cranial, pertains to the skull. And 12, cephalic, pertains to the head. Number 13, caudal, pertains to the tail. An example of 12 and 13 together would be the cephalocaudal sequence of development of the human body from the head to the tail. Number 14 is the proximal and the distal aspects of something. Proximal means closest to or the first segment of a finger or toe. Distal means the last segment or the part that's furthest away, the distant aspect. Number 15, plantar, pertains to the sole of the foot, like plantar warts, warts on the bottom of the foot or the sole. Number 16, palmar, pertains to the palm of the hand. Now number 17 is flexion and extension. Flexion is a process of bending, closing, and extension is the process of stretching outward. You take your fingers, you flex them, you bend them together, and extension is to stretch them out. Number 18 is pronation and supination. When you pronate something, you turn it down, like the body in a downward position or the hand in a downward position. Supination is turning something up, like the body in a face-up position or supinating the palm of the hand, turning it up. Now, in this frame, you have learned the key planes of the body and body directions and positions. When you take a course in kinesiology, the process of studying motion, you'll learn some additional body movements and directions. An example would be circumduction, the process of drawing around a pivotal point, such as drawing the arm around the shoulder.